is not planted.
This is not really a question. I just wanted to add a very small comment as one of the actresses and the girlfriend of the director. So I've sort of been around for the whole creative process. I just wanted to add what the significance or the message of the film was to me as well, how I witnessed it from writing to them filming it, working with the actors, talking to real people and then finding out and saying, hey, you know, this stuff actually happens to people and this is actually how they react. I think the message to me is The Outsiders is not just about immigrants in a particular country. It's The Outsiders is about the difficulties that we have in making connections, in belonging. And this this happens either when we are transplanted to a new environment, but also not necessarily so. You saw the difficulty of making a connection within a loving, comfortable relationship. The two guys, they had everything, they had nothing to worry about, yet at moments there was still a disconnect. They couldn't connect to each other properly. Vic, the MNC worker turned artist, you know, at times you felt like he was disconnected from himself or struggling to figure out a connection to his real self. So The Outsiders, to me, is about this in many different contexts and various aspects of our lives, in many different people's lives. And ironically, that's what everybody has in common, even though they don't realize it. You know, they all have this us versus them mentality at times, but that's what makes us all very human and all the same. We all struggle with this disconnect. We all struggle with isolation and loneliness.
Thank you. Any comments, anything?
Positive message.
You mentioned it's very tight, so you pay for it out of pocket or something.
Yes. Yeah, that's true. I mean, to do something like this, we did the rounds of going to certain producers, and of course we tried a few of them, and some of them said it was not their cup of tea. Some of them were a little more honest and said, you want to get thrown out of this place? This was, mind you, a while back. We started doing this 16 months back, 18 months back, where things were slightly different. I think a lot of us have seen some changes over the past few months. Well, past year. So back then, people were still a little bit skeptical about the script. So it didn't really work out in terms of getting funding from them. So yeah, it's basically a little bit of my bread, a little bit of this butter.
How long do you think?
About 16 months. Yeah. And I had, I don't want to give you the sob story version of the thing, but it's okay. If anybody wants to find out more about how difficult it was and how every indie filmmaker sort of screams about how he lost his hair, how he went gray, how the computer crashed a number of times, how his best friends and co-producers left the town. I mean, there's a lot of stuff that happened. And of course, run-ins with the cops is always a fun thing to sort of have when you're a guerrilla filmmaker. It sort of makes you feel that you've done something, but yeah. Not that I'm looking in for trouble, but yeah.
Any more dying questions?
Just wondering, for yourself,
I'm just wondering, for yourself, what is more important, to get your ideas expressed across, brought across, or would that be commercial success for the film that you are doing? This one, and you mentioned another project that you might be embarking on, and for that one as well. What's your thing? Thanks.
Okay, I'll put in a quick word on that, and then Sid wants to answer it as well. I think being commercially successful, there are certain things that you can do, and there's certain things that you should do if you want to be commercially successful. You can work out the formula. I mean, if I wanted to make a really commercially successful film, I could do a film about a 40-year-old paraplegic divorcee who wants to reconnect with his family by making confectionaries, and he makes these pastries that are really special, and his son starts to love him again. What happens is he becomes a global success because his pastry shop is the best in the world and everybody loves those pastries, and everybody at the end of the film would get a little piece of confectionery as well when they walk out of the theater. That would please everyone. You can easily create pastries. But I think, especially if you're an indie filmmaker, you can take the risks and say stuff that you really care about or say stuff that you really are burning to say. So that's what we did with this. Not to say that the next one is going to be a complete sellout. I'm not making, I don't think that would ever happen. I tried to write a normal script for the next one. I mean, a script about a family. And it ended up going in a completely different direction, which I keep cribbing about with it, but I have to stay true to what I'm trying to do. So I think there's a chance that, I think commercial success is not something that one should think about actively, but just do something that people can relate to and people can connect with. And I think it'll take care of itself.
Yeah.
I just want to add a quick note to that. Okay, that's bad alliteration. The production company is three of us. I mean, he writes the script, he directs it, he heads the company. I score the music, and I used to live in Singapore until a year back. I mean, I'm still a PR here, very much connected with the place. And Audie, the third of us, this is a guy, you know, who used to be in a recruitment guy, right? And I mean, he was really passionate about trying to make this his career too. So when he got picked to, in the course of editing in American Film Institute, AFI, it's a very prestigious thing. So that's what he's doing right now. He'll be back. So no, my point was that in making this film, I think we really kind of got to the limits of, in terms of how much you can stretch resources to cover the maximum possible scope. If you take a look at the original screenplay that he started out with and how it's actually landed up, the completely different things. We have about one third of the characters that were there originally. So it was really challenging to try and, you know, make carry the same essence through with lesser funding, you know, lesser resources, while also doing day jobs. But you know, this having been what you know I would term in my by my standards as a success, you know, being picked at SIFF, winning an award of merit at Indie Best Gallery, a couple of screenings at the lead up to Venice. So I don't know. We hope things will pick up and we get to do things on a slightly bigger scale, because when you stop worrying about every single aspect and just focus on your role, him, his role as a writer of dialogue and directing, and you have, you know, a sound that's taken care of not by just one guy but two, three different, you know, post-production being an entirely different thing. You have sync sound recording, you know, on site. I think it would be a completely different ballgame. So for the next production, you know, whatever we're hoping for would be something, you know, much bigger with more legs, yeah. Bigger legs.
We have considerably higher funding for the next one.
We've procured some of it, and it's like astronomical compared to this. So hopefully you'll see a film that looks more like a film and less like this.
And if you...
If you like this, and you know, in any way you want to stay updated with what we do, and you know, just please go to facebook.com/theoutsidersfilm, The Outsiders Film, and like us. You know,
please like us.
Yeah, please like us.
One more last question.
Sure.
You have chosen to portray those characters in your movie. What led you to choose just those particular characters? And if you had to, you had a choice of adding another one, what would you have to do? An outsider.
Okay, that's a tough one. That's a really tough one. Okay, these are people that I know. These are people that I have. There's a little bit of me in every character as well. And there's a little bit of my friends, people that I know. So it was pretty easy to, it wasn't something which I sat down and said, who is an outsider, and then wrote this. I started writing about people I know and care about and what happens to them and tried to show that. So it was pretty organic in that sense. So I don't know if I can answer you about what kind of an outsider I would add to the milieu. So yeah, it's pretty organic that way. I mean, it may end up on an Excel spreadsheet like everything else, but it starts out like a seed in the ground, not to sound too arty. Any other questions? Any comments?
No more questions? Okay, with that, I think we'll wrap up from here. Okay, let's thank the directors again.
Thank you for being patient and curious and wonderful. Thank you.
Okay, any more questions, you can take it down with me personally.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, I'm very approachable.
Thank you.
All right, cheers. Thank you.